Hi again there, Rob here at Power Learning Solutions, and welcome to my second video in this series about making sure that our PDFs that we share with our students are accessible and that we are not excluding some of our students who have accessibility issues from being able to access those learning resources. In the previous video, if you'll recall, I told you that the old adage, a picture is worth a thousand words, is not true. When we are sharing text files with our students, when we're sharing PDFs that are actually just flat image files and that have no machine readable text. In this video, I'm going to show you a few different tricks to make sure that any PDFs we create from scratch are accessible for our students and how to fix some of those problems when you have an image only PDF to make sure it is fully accessible. I'm going to start here by doing one of the most common things that we as educators would do when creating our own PDFs from scratch, and that is saving one of our Word documents that we create, a word process document, as a PDF file to upload into one of our courses or to email out to our students or to host on a website. So I have a file here that is not formatted. I have just some text in it with a couple of pictures. And it's a really rough version of my digital accessibility cheat sheet. So I want to pretty this up a bit, make it look visually appealing, and make sure that it is fully accessible. One thing that I do not want to do is just manually format my headings for aesthetic purposes. You want to make sure that you actually tag them. I have another video available about making sure that your documents and that your resources are fully accessible for your students, where I go through all of the steps in that. But I'm just going to do that for a couple of these and save this out as a PDF in a couple of ways to show you how to do it properly. So I want to make sure that my headings are tagged as headings. This is going to create a navigation structure for anyone using a screen reader application so they can find the right place in the document. If you don't tag your headings, what's going to happen is anyone who's using a screen reader, when they return to the document, they're going to need to start from the very beginning and have the computer read out the entire document to them to find where they left off. So you want to make sure you have that navigation structure in there. It's bad enough when it's just a single page like this. Imagine a longer reading that's 20 or 30 pages or a whole book. You need to have that navigation structure. So I am going to tag my first heading here as heading level one. You can change the color schemes on this to make it as accessible as possible to comply with APA formatting, whatever you need to do. And for my overview, I'll tag that as a heading level two. And I'm going to update my heading levels here to match my current styles. So I'll make them black so they're as accessible as possible. And I'll make heading level two black. And I'll make this one a heading level two. This one will be a heading level one. And I have another heading level two down here. So my document is navigable now. I also want to make sure that I have alt text on any images before I save it as a PDF. So you can just right click on your image and you can view the alt text. There is none on it in this case. I could add some in, make it as descriptive as necessary so that your students get the point about what's in the picture. So this would be an example of a document with proper heading structure. And for this next one here, it's just the icon that we're familiar with for adding images to our web pages. So maybe I don't really want a screen reader to say anything about this. It's a decorative only image. Well, I could add alt text and say that this is the add image icon, or I can mark it as decorative. That will tell a screen reader application to skip it. My document is fully accessible and navigable now for a screen reader. So I'm going to save this Word document and I will call this accessible version. And then I'm going to save it two different ways as a PDF. Now, the best way to do this is to save it as a PDF or to export it as a PDF. That will maintain all the tags and the structures that you had in there. So you'll see now that I can grab onto the text. All of my accessibility tools that are built into Adobe Acrobat will work. The other way that some people save this as a PDF is not to export it, but to print it as a PDF. There is an option to print to PDF. You can do that, but it doesn't create a fully accessible document. It strips all of your tags out of it, so you will have the text. It can be read aloud, but you can't navigate the document, and it will remove all of the alt text on you. So your best option is to make sure that you use that export as a PDF option rather than using the print to PDF.